Hello, folks, and welcome to the Vertigo Tea Party and Let's Try Bombshell. It's developed by Interceptor Entertainment, published by 3D Realms. You can pick it up for $34.99 on Steam for Windows. It supports Steam achievements, has full controller support, and Steam cloud saves. I will be playing a free version that was provided to me in order to make this Let's Try video. And I will also be playing with a keyboard and mouse. I haven't tried it with the mouse yet, or the controller. Record, a reputation for getting things done. We'll listen to this little intro.
The tech in Washington. I know its power. But really, the why doesn't matter. What I do with it does.
All right. So this is a isometric action shooter, is how the developers described it. Ignore that little camera pop-in. That's the only time it ever happens has been here at the very beginning of the stage, at least so far. But I'm controlling with the WASD, just moving around. As you can see, I move the mouse cursor. She spins around wherever I'm aiming is where she's going to shoot. Left click shoots. Right click is the special attack, which in this case is just kind of a rail gun for this weapon. I can switch weapons with the mouse wheel. I've only got three right now, but I can also switch with the numbers.
Repeat, this is Bombshell reporting to all GDF forces. Please respond. No signal. We need to get to higher ground.
Okay, so as we talked about, this is an isometric shooter. It's got RPG elements, but they're very light. You can upgrade certain skills, so you can buy upgrades for your weapons. Other than that, not a lot of what you would consider to be strong RPG-style mechanics. So I guess this... Whoa! I haven't been to the stage yet. Oh, this is going to get us close. I'm going to actually switch to my shotgun style weapon, the Mother Flacker. The Kai you see me picking up is money. You use that to upgrade your various weapons, and I'll show you the weapon upgrades, the skill upgrades, what and whatnot. So at the top, oh god, those are fast now. Those are very fast now. At the top, you've got my health and a shield. The shield regenerates over time. And you don't take health damage unless the shield is all the way gone. As you can see, we need to be very careful because we might take some health damage here. These bugs explode. All right, our shield's back up. We're looking good. We have 240 of 250 health. You can see our money, experience. We also have some unused skill points, which I will take care of here shortly. I intentionally haven't been upgrading lately so I could show you how that process works. On the right here, we see our quests. We have two primary quests. Let me get back. These bugs are very, very slow, but they blow up into this acid, and if you step into it, it does damage to you over time. Oh, those little guys are pretty easy. They can be difficult to hit, though, just due to being so small. Let's see, at the bottom left, you can see our weapon. Right now, we're using the Ion Maiden. I just actually realized it's Ion Maiden and not Iron Maiden. I'm a bit slow sometimes. So watch this cutscene. There's not much of this. It is mostly action. I know some people cringe a little bit in cinematics, especially in action games, but there's not been very many at all. And they tend to be very short. But yeah, you can see our different weapons. You see the ammo. You can see how many bombs we have. We also have the maxi gun and the mother flacker. We also have a special ability here, which right now is the mighty punch, which I use shift to do that, and it ports you forward. And you like do a AE explosion. Here's my med packs. I've got 16 med packs. I use those with Q. T is the boots. I've only got two of those, but they make you run faster. I've actually never even used them. Oh, these we want to blow up quickly because they roll in, come in fast, and they explode, kind of like the bugs, but they don't leave a slime. And then at the bottom right, we've got our mini map. I'm gonna kind of hide back here and get in close like that, knock him down. And shotgun him in the face. Actually, it's quite hard to shoot them on the ground, which is kind of a bummer side effect of the fist attack. I mean, the fist attack's really good because it's fast, but it kind of sucks that they're hard to hit when they're on the ground like that. Also, the other thing I meant to mention, the white is our energy. As you can see, when we use that, the energy drops, but it does come back fairly quickly. And we can hold F to show our powers. We've only got two right now. We got the power slide and the mighty punch. The punch is what we were using. The slide is pretty much the same thing without an attack. It uses less energy, but at least it gets around a little bit quicker. Honestly, I haven't found a lot of use for that so far. I almost always use the mighty punch as opposed to the mighty kick. There are some Duke Nukem type references. 3D Realms, as many of you probably know. I don't know if they developed or just published. I think they just published Duke Nukem, the originals. But anyway, I got my flat cannon, which acts as like a shotgun. We've got the minigun, which does a lot of damage very quickly. It does take a little bit to spin up, but we're talking quarter of a second. Very, very fast spin up. And we have a regular gun here. Now the regular gun, you can see when we shoot it, if we stop firing, it actually regenerates ammo. That way you're never truly fully out of ammo. And there's also, of course, the alt fires. There's the rail gun that I got for this. This, I'm not gonna waste the ammo to show you, but it has like explosive rounds. And the flat gun, we have not been able to get the upgrade for yet. In fact, I'm gonna use, there we go. Sometimes the alt fire for the minigun, for some reason, I have trouble with it like working. Like I'll right click and nothing will happen. I'm not quite sure what's up with that. Doesn't happen often, but of course it's gonna happen there while I'm showing you how the game works. So the premise of the game is fairly simple. Run through these levels, blow shit up. Pretty simple in that aspect. The story is basically you're playing Shelly. I forget her last name, but she's Bombshell. With Shelly, get it, Bombshell. And basically, aliens have kidnapped the president. That sounds familiar, and we have to save her. So the game doesn't take itself like... It's kind of odd in that the game doesn't take itself seriously, but it sort of does. I feel like it's done in a tongue-in-cheek sort of a way. Like, whenever you're talking to, like, your commanding officer... that's too close when I blew him up. But it doesn't take itself overly seriously. And, I guess, I picked that up from playing, and I appreciate that. But it's not over-the-top tongue-in-cheek, like, say, something like Blood Dragon. Like, that game obviously is really, really over the top. So these guys are a pain because they shoot like a ranged spit. And the rail gun can almost one-shot these. This guy was like at half health. But the rail gun, as you can see, uses a ton of ammo. I think it uses half. Yeah, it uses 30 of your 60 ammo. So not really something you want to use if you don't have a good aim. Let's actually use that on him. If you can, there we go. And... as I said, don't use it if you don't have good aim, and I proved that you shouldn't use it if you don't have good aim. So story-wise, I mean, probably not too many people are going to pay a lot of attention to the story. It's just an excuse to go to this alien world and kill a bunch of aliens with big guns and big bombs. Speaking of bombs, let's find some enemies that are worth using bombs on here in a second. And while we wait, let's talk about some of the other aspects of the game, not gameplay related, while we get to the meat of the game. Graphically, it looks really good. This world looks pretty cool. Yeah, I am looking forward to kind of getting some different settings. I feel like I've been here a while. It's starting to get a little repetitive, but it's not bad. It still visually is appealing. Animations look good. It runs fairly well, or it runs well, period. Not fairly well. And also, the sound effects are good, the guns sound really good, etc. In particular, the music is quite good. Why is this guy's taking forever? These guys usually are not that tough. I think this one might be bugged. I'd have never had, you know what, I'm just gonna leave this guy. I've never seen one take that many shots. And they don't really die, they just kind of go back into their cocoon type thing. But, oh, here we go. We'll use our middle, actually we're gonna destroy these. And they will kill their own allies, which is good. We're gonna use a bomb to take this guy out with a middle mouse click. And again, I have not tried this with a controller. I'm thinking, with being a twin stick, it actually might work fairly well. It might even work better with a controller. To be totally honest, I'm not quite sure. We're gonna pick up all this money for gun upgrades. You cannot move the camera around. You can zoom in a little bit, and if you hold Alt, you can move the cursor to like to the edges so that you can see a little bit further. And you can actually move while you're doing that. If you're good at multitasking, that can be very handy. So far, the game's not been overly difficult though, so it's not been too necessary. One of the things that I noticed immediately that was missing from the game was how do I get to that? Let's look around. But there's no dodge. It's quite odd to me.
How can I reach that key if that pillar moves back?
With my help, sentry mode activate.
While Amiga is deployed, press Alt Fire to take control.
I didn't need to do that. I should really read the manual next time.
Oh, press. Wait, Alt? I thought you said Alt. Did you say Alt? Oh, it's control. Okay. I misread it. Oh, wait, whoops. No. Wait. Did I screw that up? Alright, let's try this again. I think I might have messed up because now he won't come out. Control brings up your weapon wheel, by the way. I never use it. I just use the controls. Yeah, because I'm clicking on it and he's not coming out. Or she. It's a robot. I don't think it really has a gender. Shit. No, there he goes. Maybe I just didn't have enough space? I don't know. I'm still not sure. I might have to rewatch that because I thought it said. Maybe it's got a timer on it. Maybe that's why. Oh, I left click. Ah, right click, right click. Okay, my bad. Sorry about that. I guess I just, like I said, I must have just misread. Oop, nope. Okay, right click again. Removes it. Okay, oh god. This sounds bad. I'm gonna try this new, oh god. Gonna try this new pistol. Hey, not doing a lot of damage. It's kind of fun to use though. I like the sound that it's making. Alright, we gotta switch back to the mother flak. It looks like we ran out of battery. Let's use the bombs on these guys. The bombs do insane damage. Like, I've not upgraded the bombs at all, and they do nutso damage. But yeah, I'm quite a fan of the music. I'm glad the music did get a little bit more intense here, because at the beginning of the stage, it was a little light, and I'm like, okay, it's not bad. But I'm waiting for the rockin' music, and here we are. So I'm glad that it did show up. So real quick, interrupt the music. I hit C to bring up basically our character screen. There we can do all of our upgrades. We can upgrade our skills, we can upgrade our weapons, etc. We can also see our various quests that we have, if we wanted to look at them here. Not quite sure why you'd want to, because they're all up here, but this might have more detail, I don't know. This shows all your stats, health, etc. Bubble shield, I don't even know what that is yet. We haven't unlocked that yet, which we need to talk about that. Skill points and XP needed for next level. So right now, we only have two abilities that we can upgrade. The Mighty Punch, which we talked about, and the Power Slide. We can all use our skill points to upgrade our health, our armor, and our energy, which is a interesting, clever way to say energy. It seems so obvious now that I see it, NRG for energy. Anyway, this is allows you to use your skills more often. You can see I've already upgraded it to two. And if I wanted to upgrade, say, Mighty Punch, which I do like because I use it a lot and it does a lot of damage, you can just highlight it. It'll tell you it increases the damage by 4. We'll go ahead and say yes. And we'll go ahead and we'll upgrade our energy. We got 3 skill points left. Let's go ahead and upgrade it once. And we'll go ahead and do Mighty Punch one more time. Oh, select your punching destination in slow motion. Ah, cool. So it does look like eventually it's not just more damage. It slows the game down. That's pretty cool. So you do get additional abilities. It's not just plus gooder. You actually get enhanced ability, which is a good thing because it hits the one of my main complaints that we'll talk about in a little bit. Here's your inventory. This is just all the items you have, med kits, etc. Here's all the weapons. Again, we only have these unlocked. Can we even upgrade Amiga? Required player level unlock. Increases Amiga damage and lowers lover boy damage. I don't even know how that thing it does attacks. Unfortunately, weapon upgrades are not only cost you money, but they're also tied to your level. You can't, like, if you have a ton of money, you can't just upgrade one weapon a lot. I don't like that. I feel like if I can buy an upgrade don't level my limit unless, or don't limit me by level unless there's a damn good reason to do so. I feel like, again, if I want to dump all my money into one weapon, you know, so be it. Anyway, so you can see we have two, the trees is just pretty standard to start with. It's just additional damage. But then you have to make a choice as far as your path. For example, this, I can't see old upgrades, unfortunately. But for example, the chain gun, I could choose either to give the bullets an electrical shock secondary effect, or I went with, or you can go with explosive bullets, which is what I went with, since it's good for area of effect. This is the Ion Maiden. We use this a lot. Increases recharge rate by 2. That's not too bad. One problem I have with this is there's no way that I can find to get back to the weapon overview. You have to click inventory and go back to weapon, because if you click this, it closes the window. And, like, I can't figure out how to leave. Like, if once I'm in here, I don't know how to get out without clicking back and forth. Let's see. Maxi Gun. We can't level because we're too low. That's fine. Mother Flacker. This is, again, where we can decide which path to go on. So we can get Stun Drums, fire shells built with an electrically charged matrix that causes electrical damage, or explosive rounds, fire special shells made with double preformed fragmentaries. Good lord, that's hard to read. Fragmentation matrices filled with explosive gel. I wasn't even close to right, but let's go with Stun Drums. Yes, we have plenty of money. It costs 2,500. We have 6,000. So we'll pick that. We will pick that. Yes. Yes. Go back out. There it goes. I don't know what I was not clicking, but... So now that is how the upgrade system works. Now, let's go ahead and move along. And hopefully the music... I'm going to mess with the music because it's very loud in my headphones. I'm not really sure... I don't know if the robot is actually helping. Oh, he is. Okay, he is shooting. So that's good. So we have a little companion. And when you shoot, when you switch weapons, he heads out. Let's go ahead and throw a bomb, because that will devastate these guys. Ah, see, now when I hold shift, it goes into slow-mo so I can aim where I went. And of course, I went right into the rock because I'm incredibly good at video games. Sometimes you can actually execute enemies, like they won't quite die, they'll just kind of like sit there staggered, and you can come up to execute them. Generally, I don't know the point, other than, hey, it's cool to execute enemies. The animations are overly long most of the time, I've found, like, and like I said, I don't know what benefit they give you. The only benefit I've seen is that at one point in the game, alright, these things are like really taking a shitload of damage lately. I'm going to wait until my charge is up to 30. But the only time I've seen it referenced... Okay, we're just going to leave. The only time I've seen it referenced that you can really use or that you get any benefit out of the fatalities is maybe it regenerates your energy. But the energy is so fast anyway, I don't see the point. I guess we're full of Mother Flacker. We are full of Mother Flacker. So let's talk about the gameplay, the gunplay, shall we say, since that's obviously the main focus of this game. So far, it's been okay, but I think maybe that's part of the problem, is it's just okay. I'm going to try using this. Ooh, oh, nice. Okay. I'm out of guns, or I'm out of, yeah, it seems to do less damage, maybe. Yeah, it does less damage, but it stuns him, which is pretty nice. Yeah, this guy. Nice. Oh, wow, that actually is really good. That stun is damn good. Up until this point, though, I found the combat to be a little weak. Like, the gunplay? Like, it's pretty much just, like, run around, aim, and shoot. There's not really a lot of... Not a lot of strategy to it. It, like I see, you just run around, shoot things. And, you know, maybe a few years ago, that would have been, like, that would have been enough. Oh, there's an execute. You can watch one of these. Rip his head off, stab it into his back, and then step on it until it squishes him. Now, I love that kind of stuff, I will admit. Like, I'm totally biased. I love, like, gruesome fatalities and things like that. But it does take a little while to do. and it can interrupt the flow of combat. It doesn't happen much that the prompt even comes up, and I don't think there's any negative to not doing them. Like, there's not, like, it's like you have to do them in order to kill the enemy. I don't think they, like, get back up if you don't execute them. But yeah, it does take a little long. Now, keep in mind, too, one thing I noticed, the developers do seem to be very proactive. I checked the forums before I started this, just to kind of see what was going on. Because, to be honest, when I first thought this game was Early Access, and I thought, okay, well, this is a good groundwork. I'll be interested to see what they come up with. But this game is actually not Early Access. It's full release. But anyway, regardless of that, the developers do seem to be very proactive. I saw several sticky posts. They said, okay, you know, you guys have said this and this and this needs work, so we're working on this. And they had screenshots of the changes they were going to make. So, for example, like, the UI takes up too much room, and it's, like, stuck off from the side. I don't like the sound of that. Okay. Just these guys, no worries. Like, the UI is not only too large, it's like kind of stuck off from the side. It's a little weird. So they said they're working on that, trying to get it closer to the edges. They're also going to, I love that. I do love the flat gun, any kind of shotgun I like, to get up close and just blast them away. That does feel nice. But they do seem to be listening to folks about the UI. They even showed screenshots of what they're trying to work as the default UI, and they're also adding what's called a minimalist UI, where it just, as you might suspect, it's minimalist and takes very little room. There's some AI issues I've noticed as well. Like, I've seen enemies just, like, standing there, ready to die. It doesn't happen a ton, but it's noticeable. It does happen. Some other things I've seen them talking about is things like the camera. I haven't had a big issue with the camera. It is a little zoomed in. Like, I would actually like to zoom out a little bit, but it's not been a huge... But once I got used to it, which didn't take long, it's like 10-15 minutes. I mean, I was almost entirely used to how far away you are. I don't know how this stuff died, but that's okay. I'll still come loot it. I'm gonna guess the explosive bugs might have killed them. Lower these pillars. But yeah, so they are working on that, so that's really positive to see. I like to see that the developers, despite it not being early access, they are listening, they are making changes. And, you know, like I say, to the point where they say, hey, look, here's pictures of what we're going to do. What do you guys think? Which, again, is, I think, really good. And I've got to be honest, I had a lot of hope for this game. So the fact that I've only been, like, meh with it so far is really disappointing, because I'm a huge fan of Duke Nukem, the original, not so much Duke Nukem Forever, even though I think that game got overly crapped on more than it really deserved, but that's neither here nor there. Regardless, I had high hopes for this game. I was hoping it was going to be a first-person shooter, but, you know, it is what it is. I like that shock. That's pretty awesome. I also like this explosive minigun. See, now things are starting to get a little bit more interesting now that we've got alternate fires for the weapons. Because up until this point, it, like I say, there was like very, very minor differences in the guns. Also, you actually do have to look out for Z-axis problems. You can see up on a hill here. That bug's a little bit below me, and I'm shooting over him. Now, as soon as he got up a little bit higher, I hit him. It does, again, something that doesn't happen a lot, but when it does, it can be a little frustrating. I've had another case where I was trying to shoot down stairs. Like, I was up top, and the enemies were down the stairs, and I kept shooting, like, the floor. But, again, little things like that you can just get used to. Or just, you know, readjust yourself. But, yeah, so far the combat has been okay. It's not been bad, but it's not been like, oh, yeah, like, I can't wait to, you know, get the new upgrade. Now I'm kind of feeling a little bit more that way now that we've gotten the special weapons. I feel like they introduced the special weapons too slowly. Or I'm sorry, that unlocked, or the ability to unlock the alt fires a little too slowly, because the normal gunplay was getting too boring, too repetitive. I'm still trying to figure out what's up with these that are like invulnerable. They seem to be like they're always against the wall. I will ignore them. Or maybe I'm just not using the right gun? I'm not sure. And you walk over these plots, you get money, etc. But yeah, it's definitely getting a little bit more opened up now. And I think I feel like they introduced the weapons to new weapons too slowly as well, because I was really getting bored with the basic weapons up until the pretty much up until the point I started recording, because you only have the main gun and that the maxi gun, that basically a chain gun, for quite a while, or what feels like quite a while. Oh, this is a shop. Oh, looks like all our guys are dead. These are our allies. There is a shop. The shop is kind of disappointing, because really the only thing you can buy is ammo, and ammo's almost never a problem. I do run out from time to time, but it's not really a big deal. You can also buy, you know, med kits and whatnot. So far, I definitely haven't needed to do that. Well, and it's also very expensive. As you can see, we've got 6,000 right now, and I've been doing a lot of the side quests and stuff. And like one ghost shell costs 4,000, so that's a ton. Even a med kit costs 1,500. And so there's not really, to me, it's not worth it. I'd rather save that money and buy gun upgrades. So I feel like the shop is mostly a waste. Maybe it comes into play on harder difficulties, but we have enough gun variation. Gun variation as in they can at least kill enemies, not necessarily in pizzazz or you know, how they function, but enough to get through, especially with the gun that, you know, regenerates. That was an awful shot. Have a bomb. I really like the bomb effect too. The bomb just feels nice when it explodes and there's a nice flash and there's enemy body parts flying everywhere. That's a good sensation. Ooh, I thought it was new for a second there. Enemy variety has been all right so far. You have your ranged enemies. You have like the small enemies that are, you know, theoretically going to attack you in packs. You have your explosive enemies that are really weak, but you want to stay away from. Then you have your kind of general grunts that are ranged and they fly around, shoot at you, etc. So it's, you know, a decent variety so far. Even though, like I say, I would much rather have. What happens if I get in here? I'm gonna guess it red being red means something. Like I can't use it yet. But, and also you can jump. I don't use jump much. I don't think it's really useful in combat. Like, I don't know if you can jump over attacks. But it's there. It's good for platforming. There is platforming in this game. And I know some of you probably cringed immediately when I said that. It's pretty forgiving for the most part. And from what I've seen, most of the... Ooh, this is nasty. Let's shock this guy. Because that guy's a little... Oh, wow. This shotgun's doing really good damage. But the parts that require, like, precision jumping are few and far between. And they tend to be for optional areas. And you can see here, I'm just walking over and I'm not falling to my death, which is very good. So don't worry too much about the platforming. And of course, I'm going to say that and I'm going to die here from jumping, probably. You can jump off the edges, though. I have done that. And when you do die, you have a few options. Oh, God. Let's use our I'm not using my special ability enough. And that shock is really nice. Because they stay shocked for quite a while. But I ran out of ammo. So right after I said, oh, ammo's never a problem. But now I feel like the gun variation is starting to get interesting because of the alt fires. For too long, it was not. It took too long to kind of get to this point. So now things are getting a little bit more interesting as far as the combat goes. What are we doing here? What are we doing here? Maybe this does something with this now? It doesn't look any different. Will it come back down? You also run into this case too sometimes where the camera gets in the way, like debris gets in the way of the camera. Again, it's not something that happens frequently, but it can be a little irritating when you're trying to fight and there's a there's an archway somewhere in the way up in the sky that's kind of in the way. I'm not gonna die for that 6 coins. As far as dying, I've started to talk about that. When you die, you have an option to either respawn, which basically respawns you where, like, in the stage you're at, but I think all the enemies remain dead, but it takes 5% of your overall cash. Oh, did I get the amulet? Is that what I got here? But I guess we're just leaving now. Let's open the map. Here's the map. One weird thing about the map that I don't like is it pulls itself back. I don't know how to just leave it. But yeah, I think I was supposed to just stay down there. All right, fair enough. Well, I forgot what I was talking about. But yeah, see, I guess. Well, let's actually just head that way. We'll kind of hit on. Wait a minute. Did I just come this way? Shit. Oh, whoa. Okay, that could have went all the way, man. Oh. Oh, Mother Flacker level 3 required. Ah, there we go. There we go. Gotcha. Duh. Probably helps to read the text. This looks like an arena type thing. Nope, maybe not. Oh, I love that. Oh, this is one of the challenges. Okay. So wait, did it tell me what the challenge was? Am I just not paying attention? Yeah, kill all enemies with the Mother Flacker. Oh, yes. Maybe I should read the text. I'm too busy trying to explain how this all works. I'm assuming alt fire. No, you cannot alt fire. Okay. That I don't like. Oh, wait, no. Wait, what? I swore I used it. Hold on. I'm doing really good now. All of a sudden. Like, super great. Yeah, okay. No, that works. I'm just an idiot. I think you can actually even use bombs in these challenges. But yeah, I haven't found many of these. Oh god. But I'm not gonna risk it because I've already did enough stupid stuff. Ah. I'm gonna try it one more time. These are optional, you don't have to do these. I'm trying to see if there's a time limit because I'm trying to look around quickly. Oh shit. Nope, come on. Oh, I'm out of flacker ammo. Well, oh, I think that's what happened. I think I ran out of flacker ammo, and I shot him with something else. My bad. I'm gonna just back it out to try to get my shield come back. I do not think there's a time limit. I'm looking around. I don't see one. You should not have got ahead of your buddies, pal. But yeah, so far my primary complaint is that it should have introduced a lot of these mechanics earlier than it did, or at least these upgrades, because the combat, which is, you know, the lifeblood of this game. Like, yeah, I mean, the voice acting and stuff is interesting, and the story, you know, man, people aren't going to really care that much about the story as long as it's some, or again, a reason to blow up aliens. Right. Oh shit. Well, that's better. Let's back over here. Oh, that wall does not count, apparently. Not high enough. Oh, that's not good. Come on. Luckily, the other enemies seem to be just kind of hanging out over there. You can seem to abuse the AI a little bit. They seem to, like, lose track of you fairly easy or get stuck up on walls. Like, that guy seemed to be... I don't know if I was too far away or if he just got stuck. Oh, shit. Nope. I really hate in these challenges that it switches weapons on you. Because I think this is the last enemy left. And if I'd have lost because I ran out of ammo, I'd have been frustrated. Nice. Got 500 Kai and Mother Flacker ammo. Sweet. But yeah, you do not need to do those. But I like that they're there. But anyway, the combat's definitely getting more interesting now that we've got, you know, more upgrades.
Does it feel like to use a portal, Shelley?
A bit of nausea. Oh, and it tinkles too.
That's not surprising. Those portals are packed with energy. The GDF think they're powered by a rare type of rock found here on Chiron. They've called it Chironite.
That's creative.
It is, actually.
Jinx.
Data suggests Chironite is a product of the catastrophe. The Cure took a horrific event and turned it into their greatest tactical strength.
just like you.
Comparisons to a genocidal alien race aren't exactly flattering, Amiga.
You've gone from the lowest point in your life to saving the President of the United States. You used that event to better yourself, unlike the Kyr. Powering down.
Alright, let's see where we're supposed to go. We're not going to complete this stage, completely. Alright, so we need to go down here. But, yeah, I did want to at least play long enough to show a little bit more of the combat. I think you understand roughly how this works by now. Let's bomb these guys. The bombs do auto-track, by the way, on the enemies, if you didn't notice. These guys aren't really worth using a bomb on, but I wanted to. We're going to ignore this little plant guy. And that guy was stuck up on this thing somehow. But I wanted to kind of hit some the highlights and lowlights before we finish wrapping up. There are side missions that you can pick up. They're pretty standard stuff, like, oh, go to this, you know, find these items and then bring them back to me. And if you explore the map, you can find them. There's one interesting thing about this game is that it's not as linear as I thought it was going to be. I figured it was just going to be like one major path of maybe a few side roads here and there. And this map doesn't really show it that well. This is probably the quote-unquote worst map as far as, like, you know, having multiple ways to go. Other maps have been a lot more open in that there's multiple paths to go with various hidden things that you could find. This one's been fairly straightforward. But that is one cool thing about the game. It does have side quests that you can do. Where if you explore the map, you'll be rewarded with these extra items to get more money and all that stuff.
I sworn I heard something. I should check it out.
Probably heard a lot of things here, but there's like the dodge thing is just really weird to me. Like, it feels like there should be a dodge. I mean, you could argue that the shift. What is this thing? Oh, execute. I gotta say, I like the executions, but I don't really know what the benefit of them is. Let's throw a bomb. Kill whatever this thing is. God, the bombs are so good. Like, seriously. They're insane. And you get refills on them fairly frequently. So it's not like they're hard to find. But if you go crazy with them, of course, you'll run out. Oh, whoops. I get my eye on the good stuff too quick. Kill that stupid plant. Let me just look through my notes here. Other things that I wanted to talk about. But yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Like I said, the one question I have, the developers are watching, is, in fact, I'll show this right now. Right here under RNG, or energy, it says refresh it with humiliation moves or dynamic kills. I'm assuming the humiliation moves are the finishing moves. I have no idea what dynamic kills is. Is it just like standard kills, or I don't know. But I definitely wish the game would have done a better job of starting off with more weapon variety. I understand they want to kind of ease the player in, both from like learning how the game works perspective and having a sense of progression. But the drawback in this game is it's simple enough. Oop, come on. It's simple enough that I don't think it's necessary, right? I feel like before the first hour, you should probably have at least one to two of the alt things upgraded. Maybe hour and a half. Because that's when the game starts getting fun. When I can start deciding, oh, I want to use my alt attack or my major attack. Ooh, this looks bad. Can I go up here? Alright, looks like we're going to have to go through this kind of quickly. Because we're taking damage over time. So it's like, oh, I can use my railgun to do a lot of damage quickly. Oh, I missed. Or, I killed one enemy, but there's a lot more. So I switch to the flat gun. Or no, I switch to the maxi gun because things are far away. Ooh, can I blow this away? No. Ooh, maybe I can bomb it. No. Whoa! Okay. Oh, the bomb actually came back to me when it didn't blow up. That's pretty cool, actually. I'm not trying to blow that up. Anyway, we'll keep going. But it's like, oh, okay, well, I killed one enemy with my rail shot, one or two rail shots, but I'm out of ammo. So now I need to switch to the minigun, and because the enemy's far away. So I do that, and I'm like, oh, the enemy's close up now. Or I use my shift to get in close, and then I switch to the flat cannon, and I use the electrical mode to stun them, and then switch to the regular mode for the kill. Like, that's where, in my opinion, that's where the combat starts to shine. That's where I'm starting to use my various abilities to my advantage. I'm spreading my attacks out, so I'm not using all of one gun's ammo. And it just feels good when it all comes together, right? Because the combat's dynamic. It's not like, this is the best weapon, so I always use this weapon. You're changing which weapon you're using based on the situation. And that's a good thing, and I would like to see that. And I think that's the game's strong point. And I feel like it's taken too long to get here. And it's not been awful. But to put it into another perspective, you might say, well, you've been playing for about two and a half hours to get here. That's not that bad. One perspective to look at that is, oh God, that's not what I meant, but, whoa. Okay, wow, I died really quick. Let's do the respawn.
Not good enough.
Well, I died really fast there, wow. 484 Kai gone. So you don't want to die a whole lot. 5% is not a lot. You also gives you kind of an incentive to spend your money. That way, if you're spending your money, if you die, then there's less money gone. But yeah, they did a lot of damage very quickly. Because I was like, I'm fine. And then I was like, nope, you're dead. Oh shit. God, seriously, bombs. Great. But with that, see, that, but that's kind of a problem. There's no defense, there's no, like, good defense. Again, you have the Mighty Punch to kind of get you out of the way. You also have that dodge. But the dodge can be a bit difficult to use, because think about it when you're fighting something. And in fact, I'll do it now. Like, obviously, this enemy's easy. But, like, if I'm trying to shoot this enemy and dodge its attacks, it seems very confused right now. I'm trying to dodge its attacks, I might want to dodge away. That means I have to move my mouse away and then switch back. Does that make sense? Stuff like that might actually be easier with a controller, because like I say, trying to shoot him, I need to dodge back. And I need to stop hitting the wrong stupid key. Dodge back, so I have to kind of keep doing this with the mouse. Now obviously if I want to dodge closer, it's not a problem because I'm already aiming that way. But a lot of times you don't want to do that because, you know, the enemy's tough and you want to use range to your advantage. Like those guys I was fighting, I'd rather, you know, be further away. Now these guys, it's not so bad.
Finally, a way out of this place.
There we go. I think it didn't like going up the hill there.
They arrived, they tried, they died.
These guys will knock you down too. Is this available for execute now? But yeah, now I'm really like starting to like it a significant amount more. Let's go over here and go up this elevator, and this is probably where we'll draw it to a close. Like I say, overall, it's been pretty fun. The combat is helpful.
Kind of augmentation, but the authorities shelved it.
I'll wait for it.
That it was dangerous. Heskel withdrew from society, only to resurface at Washington and plant the bomb that changed my life. He wanted to show the world what he could do. Now, it's my turn.
I'm gonna guess there's gonna be some dialogue here. I'm actually just gonna stand here while I kind of wrap up my thoughts so we don't get more dialogue. But yeah, so overall, I like it. I feel like the first hour and a half, 2 hours, was a little boring, a little bit too slow. And what I was going to say before when I interrupted myself with a cinematic was, keep in mind the refund time frame is 2 hours. So if your game is not getting fun by 2 hours, that's when people start doing refunds. And let's be honest, the game should be fun before 2 hours, right? Obviously you give a little wiggle room for tutorial, but I would like to see a little acceleration in getting access to these better guns, better abilities, and start putting a light on the strengths of the game a little bit but quicker. But once you kind of cross that hump to the part where I'm at, now it's starting to feel pretty cool and pretty, you know, like dynamic and a lot more enjoyable in that respect. But my other complaint is the price. For $35, I feel it's a little bit high. I think I'd feel a little more.
We just need you to save the world by yourself.
But it's a little high. I don't know how long the game is. I got the impression it's like maybe like 6 to 10, don't quote me on that one. HowLongToBeat.com gives you a good rough idea. But yeah, I mean, it just feels a little bit high for what it is. Maybe we've just been spoiled by Steam sales and whatnot, but 25 to 30 would have seemed to have been a little bit more fair. But like I say, the positive thing is that the developers seem very proactive. So if this kind of game is what you want, like a twin stick shooter action game with some light RPG elements, with some kind of a throwback to the cheesy Duke Nukem era, like commentary and you know, brutal enemy kills and things like that, then you might want to go ahead and.
You're losing.
I know. I'm gonna move around so you stop giving me a hard time. But yeah, like I say, overall, mostly positive impressions. I definitely could see how people could get bored with it initially, but once it starts to pick up, now I'm really starting to feel like I'm really enjoying myself, though the price might be just a bit steep. But anyway, thank you guys for watching. I will have links to the game and anything else I think is relevant to it in the description below the video, so make sure to check it out. Also, make sure to leave comments if you've played this, if you have any questions. If you're developers, go ahead and leave comments in the comments description below if you have any statements you want to make, whatever. Make sure to follow me on Twitter, and I'll see you next time.